What's the word, y'all? Welcome back to another article reaction. Y'all know I'm an internet general manager, so when anytime somebody comes up with an article dealing with trades of every single NBA team, I gotta tell you what I think. But this one is not necessarily giving you trade packages. I think it's just telling you, hey, whatever team should go for Chris Paul without telling you what they should trade away to get Chris Paul. So I think that could be interesting. Shout out to Andy Bailey. He is the author of this one right here. Let's hop right into it. Leave a like, subscribe if you're new. A couple days ago, we gained like 6,000 subscribers in one singular day, which is like an all-time record on this channel. So let's keep up that. Let's keep up that momentum. I know I'm not getting 6,000 a day, but let's maybe 1,000. Leave a like, subscribe. Let's get into it. First team is the Atlanta Hawks, and they should target Eric Gordon. I don't like this. Eric Gordon just signed an extension. I think it was last season. It was a pretty big extension for a guy like him. And then he came out this year and just either he wasn't healthy or he just wasn't very good. So I would hate for the Atlanta Hawks to trade for a guy like Eric Gordon. And there's a potential that he's on that downward trajectory in his career, especially with the contract that they gave him. Gordon is coming off a dreadfully inefficient 2019-2020. But he has still shown flashes of explosiveness when healthy is a big heavy. I'm good. In January, he dropped 50. Yeah, he did. But this thing, inefficient and can't stay healthy, those are two things I don't want in a player. Not to mention that he's already getting up there in age, too. I would pass on this. Then we have the Boston Celtics with Miles Turner. They're going to be connected for a very, very long time, especially when the Pacers have this logjam at the big position. We still don't know if Miles Turner Sabonis is like a healthy front court for the future, and the Boston Celtics could use a guy like Miles Turner. So I can understand why they should target him. It would be cool just to have a taller player that stretches the floor and defends. I can understand this one. Next one, we have the Brooklyn Nets and Jrue Holiday. Jrue Holiday could be that third star. People are always throwing like Bradley Beal for the third star and other ball dominant guys like that. And I'm not saying Bradley Beal is super ball dominant because we've seen him play successfully off ball. But Jrue Holiday is a guy that could just play and get no touches and still be super impactful. I can't say that about a lot of the other options that I've been seeing people throw out there. Jrue Holiday will clamp up your best player. He didn't make an all-defensive team somehow, but he would clamp up your best player and still drop you 15. And then a couple years ago, he was averaging a dub, you know? So he's a dual-threat player, and that is exactly what a guy like KD and Kyrie could use. So I love this. I just don't know what the package is. I mean, I guess we could talk about it. I mean, it could be like Spencer Dinwiddie or Caris LeVert, or they got pieces in Brooklyn to make a trade for Jrue Holiday if they really, really wanted to. Charlotte Hornets, DeMar DeRozan, they're going to have money. This offseason, DeMar DeRozan will probably, in my eyes, take his player option. It's $27.7 million, is what it's saying down here. But maybe he doesn't. Maybe he feels like he can get more than that on the open market. And if that's the case, the Charlotte Hornets will be a team that will probably throw him some type of bag. Charlotte Hornets have a lot of cap space. So I've been seeing like DeMar DeRozan, Christian Wood, Montrezl Harrell, just some of the bigger names in this free agency class associated with them because they will have money to throw the bag at somebody. They don't really need another guard unless they plan on trading one of their guards. And they're not trading Vontae. And I don't think they'll trade Terry Rozier unless it's the right package. So DeMar DeRozan will be a guy that could come in and give you some wing scoring and everything. So I would be okay with them targeting this guy. I mean, he'd probably take his player option and then a sign and trade or something is a possibility. Because I'm sure the Spurs would like to go away from this DeMar DeRozan experiment. I don't hate that one. Okay, Bulls and Chris Paul. Sure, trading for Chris Paul could probably get us into a playoff contention, especially when you think about what he did last season. And now we have Billy Donovan as our coach too, so it's like, oh, the little pieces are saying the Bulls should trade for Chris Paul. But the reason why I wouldn't, he's old. And look at this contract. Taking on Chris Paul's deal is risky. Yes, it is. For a general manager that's just getting in there, trading for Chris Paul probably wouldn't be the smartest thing, especially because it could blow up all in your face, and now Bulls fans are like, man, Kearney Shovis was the savior, and now we traded for Chris Paul, and he's old, and we got to pay him 41.4, then 44.2, and he's 35 years old in May. Ah, love me some Chris Paul. If we would guarantee the Chris Paul that we got last year for at least two more years, I would say I'm all in on trading for Chris Paul, but it's not a guarantee. Him, Zach LaVine, Lauri Markkanen will be cool. And then you can run that three-guard lineup too with him, Kobe White, and Zach LaVine. I would like that, but the risk is so, so high for a team that if we do trade for Chris Paul, what are we just getting into the playoffs? It's not like we're going to take that contract and be contending or anything. So that's why I would probably say no. Next, Cleveland Cavaliers get draft picks. Sure, continue that build. Continue that rebuild. Get as many draft picks as possible. Takes as many shots as getting that next star player for your organization. I'm cool with this. I don't know how you do that. I mean, oh, well, you got Kevin Love to dump off. Larry Nance was cool, and they got Drummond. But they traded for Drummond and gave up like a second round pick for him. So I don't know if he's going to have any value. But yes, continue to stockpile draft picks. Victor Oladipo for the Dallas Mavericks is also a name I've seen a bunch, whether it be on Twitter or also other Bleacher Report articles. It would make sense. The only thing is you're going to have to be the one to pay him and maybe trading for him, letting him play within the system of Luka and Kristaps. You won't have to pay him a lot of money. I don't know if Victor Oladipo's agent and him believe that he's worth on the market, because he just came off this ACL, wasn't it a quad injury or something? And he didn't look amazing when he was there. I could see him fitting very well alongside Luka, though. It's just depending on which version of him are we getting. Are we getting the all-star caliber version, or are we getting the watered down, a good starter, but not anything greater than that, Victor Oladipo. Then we have Denver Nuggets, Bradley Beal. Sure, I like this. Nikola Jokic, 25 years old, Jamal Murray, and Michael Porter Jr. are both younger than him. What would be the package we put together to get a Bradley Beal, especially considering the front office for the Washington Wizards have said 1,000 times that he is not even on the trade board? You know what I'm saying? So you would have to really wow them away with some type of trade, but it would be dope to see a guy like Bradley Beal play for them. I do like that Jamal Murray's defense has been a lot better in the bubble and in the playoffs, so you don't really worry about Bradley Beal and Jamal Murray backcourt as much, because Jamal Murray has stepped it up on the defensive side of the ball. And that's crazy, because I remember early in the bubble they were calling them the Denver Nuggets because they had no D, and now they play pretty solid defense nowadays. So it's just crazy how a quick mindset change can change a lot of different things. I don't know what the package would look like, but sure, I'd be okay with a Jamal Murray, Bradley Beal backcourt with Jokic. Come on, man. That team is ridiculous. Talking about them being in the conference finals this year, if they can add Bradley Beal and not give up anything of significance, and only thing of significance I'm thinking about are their two top pieces, that'll be a scary team. The Detroit Pistons, Nicholas Batum. Look. You heard my voice, Nicholas Batum. I was confused. And then even the article says, Nicholas Batum? Yes, this particular slide does it. Confusing. I don't really. Okay. The Warriors, Aaron Gordon. I like that idea a lot. If somehow the Orlando Magic can turn Aaron Gordon into the second overall pick, that would be beautiful for them. And that's not saying that Aaron Gordon isn't valuable or he's not a good player, because I think the exact opposite. But I do think that he could use a city change, an organization change for him to blossom, because it just hasn't really happened in Orlando. And maybe with that second overall pick, you can hit on, I'm talking about the Orlando Magic, you can hit on the next star that y'all been waiting for. I don't know. Dwayne Dedmon. Whoa, and I was thinking about, like, I've been thinking about this a lot since the Houston Rockets got eliminated from the playoffs. What is a big center that can also stretch the floor so you can still play five out? Dwayne Dedmon could be that guy. Now, last season, he was not very good. I mean, he signed that contract with the Sacramento Kings and then wasn't good. He's complaining about his minutes, and then he got the minutes and he wasn't shooting the ball well. But I am a believer that the season we saw before that, when he was hitting his threes and stuff, when he was with Atlanta before they got him back, is the Dwayne Dedmon that a team could get. So I could see them taking a stab at Dwayne Dedmon and be like, hey, you're our five. Set some hard screens, pick and pop, play some defense. That's not bad. I'm not against the Dwayne Dedmon Houston Rockets idea. That's pretty cool. Indiana Pacers, Gordon Hayward. This is kind of the swap that they just had with Miles Turner. They talked about this a bunch. I like Gordon Hayward. I'm trying to figure out that wing position, because they got Jeremy Lamb, who's coming off a Achilles tear or something like that. They got Bubble TJ Warren. So I guess you run Gordon Hayward at the four, and in this hypothetical situation, Sabonis is your five. They got to figure out their coaching situation first and then try to figure out that guy's idea and figure out. I mean, there's a lot of things Indiana can do this offseason, which is very interesting. They got a lot of pieces, a coaching open up, coaching opportunity. So it's a lot of things could change with the Indiana Pacers for the better or for the worse. Rudy Gay with the Clippers. Sure. I don't really have an opinion on that. Derrick Rose for the Lakers. Let's count it up. Let's get D. Rose in contention, baby. I'm okay with that. Get him to a team that he can actually play meaningful minutes, and the Lakers could be that. Cool. Derrick Rose never quite made it back to MVP form, but at least in terms of offense, it's close. All right. Gordon Hayward for the Memphis Grizzlies. Let's just throw Gordon Hayward to every single team. But I like this actually as well. Gordon Hayward is such a nice player. The only thing is that he's going to be taking up that option, right? Isn't it like $30-something million? And that's a little scary. But Gordon Hayward is an impactful player when he's on the court. And I could see him fitting pretty solidly along in the Memphis Grizzlies uniform for sure. Miami Heat, Kyle Lowry. That'll be interesting. I don't like the idea of trading for that because, I mean, the Miami Heat fans are already photoshopping Giannis in a Heat jersey. They're photoshopping every NBA star in a Heat jersey. And trading for Kyle Lowry kind of prevents the idea of having the money available for having the Photoshop Giannis turning into a reality. Add any of those stars. Oh, right. That's exactly what it's saying, right? We must preserve our 2021 cap space. Yes, exactly what they're saying. Giannis, Kawhi, adding any of those. I'm okay with that one. Chris Paul, Milwaukee Bucks, agreed. If you watch any of the videos on this channel, I think this is the match made in heaven. I would say yes to that 100%. Minnesota Timberwolves and Aaron Gordon alongside Cat, bro. The Timberwolves could be very, very fun, interesting team. Now, I'm not trading the first overall pick for Aaron Gordon. So what is the other situation that we could, and they don't have their 2021 first round pick because that's with the Warriors right now. So how do we end up getting Aaron Gordon without trading the first overall pick? I don't know. And they don't give a suggestion here at all. I'm not trading the first overall pick for Aaron Gordon. I'm sorry. But if there's another package they could get for Aaron Gordon, count me in. James Johnson and, I don't know. I just said James Johnson's got a big old contract. Caris LeVert with the Pelicans. That's just a switcheroony for the Brooklyn Nets. Cool. New York Knicks, Chris Paul has been tied together a lot too. They're trying to change the culture in New York, trying to get winning basketball back. And Chris Paul with Tom Thibodeau, 35-year-old Chris Paul with Tom Thibodeau playing 48 minutes a game would be interesting. I wouldn't be against it. I think Knicks fans, so I've seen both sides. Some Knicks fans, like, yes, bring in Chris Paul. I've seen some Knicks fans, like, stay far away from Chris Paul. So I don't know what the front office and them want to do with, was it Leon Rose? Is that the right guy in charge of things over there? I've seen it both ways. I could see basically the same thing I said with the Chicago Bulls, right? Where, like, I could see you trading for Chris Paul and get into a competent team and changing some culture. But there's also a world where you're going to have to pay him this amount of money for him to just be good and maybe not the all NBA player he was last year. Next, draft picks for the OKC Thunder. I mean, it's not like they already got 37 of them. Just keep adding them. Yeah, let's do that. I mean, they didn't re-sign Billy Donovan because they were about to go hard rebuild. It seems like Chris Paul getting traded, maybe Steven Adams, Gallinari, free agent, all of this. So yeah, just get more draft picks and just stockpile them like it's a KOT4Q video. Spencer Dinwiddie for the Orlando Magic. Sure, I guess. Back in November, the Ringer's Kevin O'Connor wrote that the Orlando Magic were scouring the trade market for scoring help. Okay, Spencer Dinwiddie would help the scoring help for sure. If the Brooklyn Nets, yep, he and Markelle Fultz could face multiple positionless backcourts. I could see that working out pretty well, I guess. I'm just thinking about the possible trade package to make that happen. Then we have Buddy Hield basically saying, going onto Instagram, liking pictures, commenting on things, saying he would love to play in Philly. That would be, come on, man. Philly, what do Philly need? Floor spacing. What does Buddy Hield provide? Floor spacing. You know, one of the most lethal shooters in the league right now. I don't know what the trade package looks like. What do the Sacramento Kings want? I've been seeing people throw like Al Horford, and if the Kings end up trading Buddy Hield and get Al Horford's big old contract, oh man, it's an L. It's an L for them. But a W for Buddy Hield and a W for Philly. A W for both. The key is to whether Sacramento would still have any interest in Al Horford under a different front office. The team was prepared to offer a massive deal for the veteran center. I don't remember that. If the new front office still wanted, make it happen. Match made in heaven. Trey Lyles for the Suns. I mean, I haven't seen Trey Lyles play basketball since his, like, rookie season, I feel like. So I didn't really have an opinion on that. Ben Simmons for the Portland Trail Blazers. Why do I keep seeing this? CJ McCollum getting traded for Ben Simmons. I could see, like, why both fans would be interested in that. I mean, I could obviously see a bunch of Philly fans saying, no way, because we have an all-NBA player. We're not trading away for CJ. But, like, fit-wise, CJ would probably work more with Joel Embiid. But you probably want a little bit more for Ben Simmons, considering he was an all-NBA player, all-defensive player. Then you have Victor Oladipo of the Sacramento Kings. The Spurs, Aaron Gordon. Every team could use an Aaron Gordon, is what they're saying. For the same reason that I'm probably saying, is that a trade for him in a different spot could blossom him into being the player that they wanted him when they drafted him 4th, 5th overall. RJ, we traded Ricky RJ? Okay. If the Toronto Raptors, opt to lean for a fresh start with Pascal and OG Anunoby and Norman Powell, letting Marcus Saul and them walk, shopping Kyle Lowry might be. Oh, so you're saying that you trade Kyle Lowry to New York for RJ Barrett? New York fans, y'all want. I don't think you do. If the New York Knicks were looking to speed up the process under new head coach Tom Thibodeau, a new point guard would likely. No, you don't want to. I don't understand this notion of speeding up the rebuild. And what does Kyle Lowry is a winning player. Do not get me wrong. But if you're trading young guy, RJ Barrett for Kyle Lowry, sure, you could maybe get into playoff contention, but he's not about to get you anywhere further than that by himself. You get what I'm saying? I would not do this deal if I'm New York. I'm sorry. I still think that RJ has endless potential. Sure, he didn't make an All-NBA team, and you can be mad about that, but he's definitely better than trade my young piece for a 30-plus-year-old point guard. You know? And it would be very Knicks-like for them to trade for an aging point guard and him come to New York and just not be as good as he was the previous 5-6 years. Kevin Love with the Utah Jazz would be cool. That would be really cool. Throw Mike Conley's expiring contract and some draft capital, and you probably get a yes from Cleveland Cavaliers. Watch the Wizards salary match in Knicks. What the heck does that mean? Through no fault of injury to play the Watch the Wizards. Julius Randle for Bobby Portis. What was this article? Was it cool? It had a lot of things that I can agree with. It definitely had a lot of things I'm like, no. Like, one, that's a no. Two, that's a eh. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of things that I could agree with, a lot of things I didn't agree with. Overall, I guess this is what makes a good article. Leave a like on the video. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. And I'll be back soon. Bye.